Hey Pokemon trainers, and welcome to today's video. I'm joined by my brother Chris, and today we're going to be talking about our GoFest experience.
How's it going, everyone? Good to be here.
Hey, welcome, Chris. So for this video, Chris and I will be going through what we liked about the event, what we thought could be improved, as well as our general thoughts. We also want to know about your GoFest experience, so feel free to leave your thoughts in the comments. So for this discussion, we're going to go into five different parts. We're going to talk about the habitats from the first day, the spawns for the event, the branch special research, the Meloetta encounter, and then the raids from the second day. So Chris, why don't you start us off with your thoughts on the habitats?
Yeah, so I found many of the habitats to be pretty good, about on par with last year, with some great new spawns and shinies making it really great. There were occasional duds throughout it, like Tynamo, Vanillite, and Cacnea, but honestly, it didn't really ruin the experience at all. For me, Cave was a personal favorite, with great Pokemon like Galarian Stunfisk, Snorlax, and Dino. And I think Jungle was the weakest, with a lot more commonly featured Pokemon, but the regional Chaton made it a lot better, and overall, all four of them were still really fun.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. So in terms of the habitats, I really enjoyed the four that they chose this year. The spawns during each hour were pretty solid, and of the four, I'd say that Jungle was probably the weakest with the rare and shiny spawns, but it still had a great variety. I was also a fan of how they incorporated the new shinies into each hour. The new shinies introduced from last year's GoFest were tied to specific hours, whereas this year's were available in all of the habitats. It made it so if you missed an hour, you wouldn't miss a chance to get any of the new shinies.
Yeah, I really liked that, how Whismur and Chimecho and all the new shinies were present in all the habitats.
It was definitely an improvement from last year. As for my favorite habitat, I would have to say that the ocean was the best. It had the most shinies that I needed from any hour, including Chinchou, Timpul, Alolamola, and Sock. And by the end of the event, I managed to get three of the four, so I was pretty happy about that.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Ocean was a fantastic one. I still think Cave was my personal favorite. I was actually able to get a shiny Dino during that, which was super exciting. But I really found that all of the habitats were pretty good overall.
Yeah, that's definitely true. So next up, we're going to move into the branched special research. Unfortunately, I still haven't had a chance to complete my special research. During GoFest, I was too focused on the catching and the raiding aspect, so I completely forgot to complete it. But I know you did, so why don't you tell us what you thought about it?
Yeah, so it was a really fun special research. It was actually the second branch special research that we've had ever. The first one was back in the Bidoof day. It had a humorous debut there where you would choose one of two routes that were actually exactly the same. And I thought that was really funny. But here, it was fully realized where you could choose between the rock route or the pop route.
Yeah, we can all thank our Lord and Savior Bidoof for making that possible.
Yeah, and I think it was really cool that they kind of played into the two Pikachu here with Rock and Pop. And so you could choose either one, and you could also choose other members of your kind of concert that you were putting together. So you could choose between Galarian Ponyta or Zigzagoon or Flygon and Gardevoir, and you can kind of mix and match. And so I thought that was really fun.
Yeah, that was a pretty cool aspect of it. I thought it was going to be like when they first announced it, it was like you get the Rock side, you get Flygon and Galarian Zigzagoon, and if you went Pop, you got Gardevoir and Ponyta. But that ability to mix and match Pokemon, like, that was really cool. I'm glad they went through with that.
Yeah, same here. I will say one of the more frustrating elements of the event was the photobombs, where you had to complete the entire special research story just to get your costume Pikachu and Flygon or Gardevoir photobombs.
Yeah, that was a real bummer. I thought that the photobombs were going to come once you hit that part of the research, or they even could have made it, you know, just throughout the day, but, you know, I definitely agree that they should have put more encounters in the special research, so that way, you know, players could have access to more without having to rush through their special research.
I agree with that. I remember earlier in the day, I had heard that you could get special encounters from photobombs, and I took a few pictures, and I know you did too, and we didn't get anything. We didn't realize that you had to finish the entire special research. So Niantic's communication wasn't really that great, so many people, including both of us, missed the extra photobomb encounters.
If they gave us like a special research that just included encounters, like, I'd be fine with that. just give us like one or two encounters with the options again to get either the Rock or the Pop Pikachu.
Yeah, definitely. I'd be really happy to get that. It gives you more opportunities to trade with people who got the other one.
Niantic, if you're listening, you got to make it happen. You got to get the special research out.
Please do, Niantic. We're begging.
We're begging. So next up, we're going to talk about the specific Pokemon from that research, which was the mythical Pokemon Meloetta. Like I said before, I hadn't completed the research just yet, but I saw a clip of the encounter on YouTube, and I gotta say, it looked pretty cool.
Yeah, it was really, really fun. Obviously, I was the only one to get Meloetta as of now out of the two of us, and I was really excited to see the encounter. And I thought the whole concert performance that they did for it was really cool. It made it really different from the other mythicals, Mew and Celebi and Jirachi.
Oh, definitely. It really tied the whole music theme together.
Absolutely. But oddly enough, though, Meloetta didn't get Relic Song when it was released here. That was a move that actually was data mined just a few weeks before GoFest. And so everyone was expecting it to get that move, just like Victini did last year, where it got V-Create right when it was released. But perhaps it will get this move when Meloetta becomes available for all the players.
That's true. You know, every year they always release the GoFest mythical to everyone around like September, October. So hopefully when that happens, you'll be able to TM it away if you got the Meloetta already.
Yeah, I think that'd be really cool.
So the last part of day one that we have to talk about are the raids. During the day, we had special 1- and 3-star raids, and in 5-star raids, we had Mewtwo.
Yeah, obviously raids weren't the main focus of the first day, but I found the raids on this day to be pretty good. A lot of people love the Dino raids, myself included, and the costume Galarian Ponyta and Zigzagoon were all pretty solid. James can vouch, but I even got a shiny costume Ponyta on my first raid.
That you did. That was really cool. And we were both super surprised by that.
Yep, it was pretty exciting.
That being said, there's a couple things that could have been done differently. I wasn't really a fan of the 3-star raids, which included Kranidos, Galarian Weezing, and Hitmontop. It just kind of felt totally random, and it just didn't seem like something that people really wanted. I mean, I'm sure there's people that still did it and wanted to do it, but I feel like for the most part, everyone was either going for Dinos or Mewtwos.
I agree with that. The 3-stars seem just kind of random and out of place, and I think there's a bunch of cool things they still could have done with them, like doing the Gardevoir and Flygons that were exclusive to the special research photo bombs.
Right, exactly. I also felt that the first day raid should have had reduced timers like the second day. Each egg would have a 5-minute countdown and 20 to 30 minutes with the raid boss.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I think it was really weird when you have such an energetic event like GoFest where everyone's moving around and constantly doing things that you have a lot of these raid eggs that are just sitting there for a whole hour when they really don't need to be.
Yeah, exactly. I know the first day was focused on catching, but this was the prime time to raid for Dino. I'm pretty sure we only found 5 to 6 when we were on campus. It also felt like the respawn rate was low because there was usually just 2 to 3 active raids running at a time. It's just something that I hope they do both days for next year's event. So now that we've talked about the day one raids, let's talk about day two. As you know, the second day was super crazy because they brought back every single legendary that's been available in Pokemon Go. This meant you had Kyogre, Dialga, Registeel, Xerneas, you name it, they were all there.
Yeah, I was a little unsure about how it was going to work because with the reduced timers and so many legendaries, I really thought it was going to be impossible to coordinate. But at the end of the day, I think we can both say it worked out pretty okay.
Most definitely. That being said, there was one issue I had, and let me know in the comments if you experienced this as well, but there were a lot of glitches in the raid lobbies where if you joined a raid, it either showed your previous raiding group or it was just completely blank. You couldn't see anybody at all. And I'm sure a lot of people lost passes because, you know, they see there's like 5 or 6 people in a raid and then they go in and it's just them.
Yeah, I thought that was really kind of tricky. I know there were points on the day where you and I were doing different raids. And I remember for myself seeing just only me and one other person in the lobby, despite it saying 6 people. And so it was kind of troubling to almost see, were we going to beat this? Were there actually 2 people in it? Were there 6 people in it? It was really kind of weird overall.
Yeah, and because of this issue, I did manage to lose a best friend bonus. I had someone that I had one day from hitting best friends with, and because I didn't see that they had joined the raid, we hit best friends, and I lost out on the 100,000 experience, which isn't a huge issue, but it was just kind of annoying to see it and be like, oh, we were waiting for this just to have it happen randomly, you know?
Yeah, that's definitely disappointing. So I really hope Niantic doesn't let that happen again in any future events, especially with an event that's so focused on raiding.
I mean, I have seen this a few times, but not to this level. Like, it felt like 9 out of 10 raids had this issue. And I think that's just because so many people were out raiding and, like, there was just so much going on with the servers.
Yeah, I think you're probably right with that. But other than those glitches, I think we can both agree that it was a pretty good experience overall.
Yeah, it was pretty awesome seeing a lot of old legendaries return. It's definitely been a minute since we've seen Dialga, Palkia, Reshiram, and Zekrom, so those were pretty exciting to raid. So before we give our overall thoughts for GoFest this year, feel free to let us know in the comments what your experiences with GoFest were, and also let me know if you had those issues with the raid lobbies. I'm really curious to see how many people that happened to. And also, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see other cool stuff on the channel, be sure to give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. We have a ton of cool stuff in the pipeline and we can't wait to show it to you. So overall, Chris, what did you think of this year's GoFest?
Honestly, I found this event to be really great, and compared to last year, I thought it was a pretty good improvement. I think the spawns were just kind of generally better, with a lot of new shinies and even ones that we've seen throughout this year since last GoFest, just kind of rounding things out a lot better.
I absolutely agree. And I also felt that the second day was less hectic than it was last year. You know, we had the spawns off incense, we had the Team Rocket stuff, the special research, and I think that's the time that Dialga and Palkia returned, so there was a lot of stuff happening at once, and it was just kind of just hard to focus. Whereas this year, it was just focused on raiding, so I really enjoyed that.
Oh, absolutely. I remember I wasn't a fan of last year's day two, but I think this year, having all the legendaries and just worrying about that and the spawns was a lot better. And it's honestly something that kind of surprised me, because I thought the legendaries were going to be a total dumpster fire, but instead, they were really fun.
Yeah, definitely. I think we can both agree that the servers were much better this year. There wasn't any significant downtime like there was last year.
Yeah, I remember last year there was like a whole hour where we were down globally, and that's what caused one of the makeup days.
It was nice to be able to play the whole event without any interruption, so that was pretty great. All right, and were there any other improvements that you'd like to see from this year for next year's GoFest?
Yeah, I definitely think kind of ironing out some of those glitches that we had with the raids would make for a lot more enjoyable experience. And so I hope they kind of smooth that out a little bit next time. But I think a lot of just keeping the spawns that they had this year and kind of improving upon that would be really fun for next year. And I would look forward to see what they do with the day two next year.
Yeah, definitely. They really did a major overhaul from last year's GoFest to this year's. And I'd like to see a lot of this year's features return next year, you know, having the new shinies be available all throughout the event. The hours are great. Everything about it. Just, you know, some of that stuff on the server side, but other than that, I thought it was great.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Now, James, I know we had some fun experiences throughout the day. What do you have to say about our overall GoFest experience?
Overall, I really enjoyed it. This was the first year that we did GoFest together, because last year I was in Florida doing it. But, you know, overall, I loved everything they did in-game. Out of game, you know, the weather was great. We only had like 45 minutes of rain on the second day, so there weren't really a lot of intrusions. Also, my phone is at the end of its lifespan, so there were some technical difficulties with the battery. But that being said, we did manage to make it through to the end, which was pretty great. I thought it was a great experience, and I can't wait for next year.
Yeah, me neither.
So guys, that about wraps up our GoFest experience video. Thank you so much for watching. We really appreciate you guys tuning in. Before we head out for the day, I just want to give a couple quick updates. Next Friday, there will be an Eeveelution analysis video to help you prepare for EeveeCom Day. Then the following week, Chris will be doing another Perfecting Pokemon video. Any chance you can give us a hint as to who's coming next?
Yeah, it's an incredibly rare Pokemon. You might have seen one or two. And it's a Pokemon from Generation 6, so tune in to see how this Pokemon can be perfected next week.
Ooh, Gen 6 Pokemon. That sounds pretty exciting.
Yep, so I hope you all tune in.
So yeah, that's going to wrap things up. Chris, thank you so much for coming on today. We really appreciate having you and talking about our GoFest experience.
Yeah, thanks for having me on. It was a pleasure.
So until next time, thank you all so much for watching. We hope you have a great day, and we'll see you all in the next video. Take care.